It's PC Edwards from Sand Hill Police Station. Yes, we have found him. No, he's all right. Stop it, you.
Can't you get one of your neighbours to look after the other children?
I find that fine.
Yes, we would appreciate that. Right, well, come straight to the front desk and we'll see you in about 20 minutes, all right? Okay, thank you. Goodbye.
Give me that
leave
thing!
My hand.
Give me that thing! Give me
that
thing!
No,
fucking CID officers. Chap's got in, some would say.
Should have been back from weekend home leave.
What do you think of that, then?
Terrific.
Done all the artwork myself. Now all we have to do is sell some tickets.
Yeah, right. Now, what do you want me to do about this missing leg?
Who is it?
Mullins.
He'll be at home. Look at that pain in the arse, that boy. What nick covers his address?
Sun Hill.
Right, let's teach the little bastard a lesson. Send him a message on the printer and mark it up. Prison escapee, dangerous.
Yeah, but ain't that a bit risky? They're likely to send the heavy mob round there with shooters and things.
As I said, teach the little bastard a lesson.
Sarge? How about this? We've got a prison escapee on the manor.
Yeah. No, I'll have to get back to her on that. All right, leave it with me. Let me have a look. Wolfie Mullins. There's a name that keeps haunting me.
Be dangerous, Sarge?
Alfie, anything but?
Yeah, I've got it. The cracksman. Yes, safe-breaker, key man, whatever you call him. He's serving a long stretch. 15 years, yeah?
That's what I call good local knowledge.
Yeah, well, I remember reading a file or something about him being on home leave. He's on one of those rehabilitation schemes for long-term prisoners, am I right?
That's right, love. You're on the ball. But Alfie Mullins is not a prison escapee.
But it says on there,
I don't care what it says here. I'm telling you, Alfie Mullins is not a prison escapee. And he's far from bloody dangerous. I wish they wouldn't put things like this on messages. It's totally misleading in Alfie's case. Alfie is simply a fail-to-return waller. There is a difference. And the sooner you lot learn what life is really about, the better this job will be. Never mind. I'm wasting my words. Go on then. Get on with whatever you gotta do. I'll handle this one. And I guarantee you, Alfie Mullins will be back in Nick by tomorrow morning under his own steam.
What's all the excitement?
Tom, just the man. You do me a favour.
Yeah?
Look, I know you're not on for a while, but could you relieve me for about an hour? I want to pop out. Look at
this. Yeah, sure. Alfie Mullins, eh? Dangerous. Approach with caution.
Yeah.
Don't get him like Alfie anymore. More's the pity.
Yeah, make our job a lot easier, wouldn't it?
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Taff?
Sarge?
Look, I want to take him out and show him that there's more to police work than banging down people's doors and twisting arms up their backs. Right.
Keys, Bobby.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, Tom, see you in about an hour, yeah?
Hey, hang on, what am I supposed to do with him?
Needs a nappy change at 8:30.
And don't bruise him.
Oh, you little monster, that's all over my new skirt. I'll murder you.
You're not the maternal type, eh, Taff?
It's all a question of finding the right man, Sarge. This Alfie Mullins, he sounds like quite a character. Is that where we're going now? To his address?
Yeah. He's expecting me. Someone's nicked my bloody helmet. Whose is this one? That's a lot of good, isn't it?
It's a bit large. Probably Dave Litton's.
Ah, that'll do. Come on.
He was saying he was expecting you. I don't quite understand that.
Look, there are some things they don't teach you in England, Taff. And you won't learn them out of any police manual either. It's all about experience. That's why I got uptight in there. That phrase, prison escapee, it just grates on me. That's the trouble with this job sometimes. There's nothing in the middle. It's either black or white, and it doesn't cater for people like Alfie, you see? I mean, Alfie, poor old soul, he's one of those in that grey area in the middle. Oh, he's expecting me, all right. You don't know what I'm talking about, do you, your Welsh toad?
To be frank, Sarge, I haven't a clue.
No, I don't suppose you do. Not many people would. You know, when I first came on this ground, I was a bit like you, naive.
What?
Alfie Mullins was already a household name.
brilliant, they said. Wasn't a safe he couldn't open.
Real old-fashioned cracksman, was he, sir?
One of the best. Villains used to queue up for his services. The only problem was, he always used to leave his mark. Like, signing his name, it was.
What was this mark?
M.O., he always tidied up after himself. No matter where he was, left it as clean as a whistle.
The gentleman took a pride in his work,
A real professional. The only trouble was, it always got him dragged into nick, and usually before the loot had been shared out.
So the others always got the money?
Yeah, and poor old Alfie got the glory and the porridge. There was plenty of that being dished out, I can tell you. All right, Lionel?
Terrible, but I'm thinking of joining your team, aren't I?
What, you're going to give this up? Come and join... Oh, are you all right? I'll see you.
Didn't Alfie ever shock the others? You know, the ones he was doing the jobs with?
Alfie Grass, never. No, and he always pleaded guilty. And the bigger the job, the longer the sentence. And finally, he got this 15 stretch, and that really did him up, that did. They didn't get a penny out of the job either, contrary to what other people were thinking. Including the judge, but then that's the story of his life.
What are you doing here?
Well, what are you doing with that lot?
Oh, these are beef tomatoes. They're great. You're having with two veg.
You're having with two veg. I bet you do, don't you?
Well, don't hang about. Trey's bad enough. Perhaps seeing you lot wandering up.
Look after yourself.
What a waste of a life.
Oh, you're...
Sorry, sir.
All right, kid? Now, you're beginning to understand, but that's not the saddest part of it. You see, I'll look at this bloke. What are you doing with that lot? You looking for the lorry to put them back on, are you?
Never. I've got some lovely rhubarb, just keep you moving.
Yeah, I bet it will, won't it? See you. You behave yourself. Yeah, the saddest part of it was last year he was recommended for one of those pre-release schemes. You know, a weekend at home with the family, preparation for the big wide world, that sort of thing.
And what happened?
Well, his first leave was just before Christmas. Alfie came out of the scrubs that morning, obligatory brown paper parcel underneath the arm. Suddenly, the old Bill weren't going about their business in long capes riding bicycles. Villains were talking about blaggings, armed robberies. No one wanted to know him. The days of the cracksmen were over. Sticking sawn-off shotguns under bank clerks' noses was more fashionable, more effective. It was a different world, one that poor old Alfie couldn't adjust to. 6 o'clock that evening, he was back, knocking on the prison door, pleading to be let back in.
Poor old man. Did he ever get over it?
No. He only comes home now because he's forced to. They literally have to chuck him out of the nick. Psychologically, he fears every moment. Oh, he goes through this charade of pretending not to want to go back, just to please his missus. And sometimes, like now, I'm part of that charade.
So Sergeant cries he's let out?
Yeah, that's right. The mean old sergeant banging on his door.
Sounds more like Punch and Judy.
Yeah, why don't you see Mrs. Mullins?
What are you on, Cryer?
Morning, Eileen. Bacon, bacon. You got on the go there, then?
Mind your own business.
Come on, Eileen. You know better than that. Stop messing me about.
Why don't you lot bloody well leave him alone?
Come on.
You're nothing
but... That's enough of that. From the valleys, this one got tender ears. Not used to your kind of language. Come on, me old darling.
Excuse us, listen.
Wasting your time anyway. It's not here. Went back to the nick this morning.
Bacon smells good. Mind if you have a look around then, eh?
Why bother asking? You're going to please your bloody selves anyway. Come round here upsetting the household.
Right, Eileen. If you see him, and I'm sure you will, tell him the deadline is 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. I want him safely tucked up in the scrubs by then, and if not, I'm going to come knocking on your door. Eileen, you hear me? Don't even lose him remission, do we?
Told you, didn't I? He's back there in the nick. Come round here threatening me.
Anyway, they're showing the blue lamp in the prison nick this week. One of Alfie's favourites. He won't want to miss that now, will he? Yeah, do you know what? I think Alfie's bacon's burning.
See what you made me do? All right, out you two.
Yeah, that thing's on tonight, all right?
Yeah, could you get a motor?
I don't need one anyway. It's an office job, petty cash, nothing heavy. Factory I used to work at as it happens.
Yeah.
Old. No, not that one, the other one.
No, I won't listen, mate. I like the old bombing when he gets on that machine.
That's it.
Then it's 10p, Carl.
Yeah.
We can take it out whatever we get tonight.
Yeah, I... Yes. And it's more than my job's worth and all. But look, I guarantee you, that Alfie Mullins will be back in your safe custody by 6 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What tools do you want me to bring tonight, Carl?
Well, the way we're going in, we won't need anything.
But bring a jemmy anyway, just in case. There's plenty of tools hanging about inside. Oh, don't forget a torch. Otherwise, we're going to look a right load of wallies groping around with a box of Swan Vestas.
Hey, it's not alarmed, is it?
No, but I'll put you onto something that was wired up.
Yeah, well, I'll let them know, that's all. Right, I'll fade in down the pub.
Yep.
Mind your own business.
Oh, well, enjoy the boxing dinner tonight, won't you? Don't get a seat too near the ringside. Don't get blood all over your best shirt.
I suppose it's not a bloody station, though, does it?
No, I shouldn't think so. Anyway, you know me, Roy. Someone of discretion. See you in the morning, eh?
Oh, Roy! What?
Your wife didn't give you that haircut, did she?
You're all staring at?
Nothing, Gov. You just startled me, that's all.
Anything serious, I'll be at this number till about one. But I'm not over the tannoy, all right, Sarge?
Right you are, Gov. I'll pass it on to the night duty.
Anything else? Roach and Dashwood can deal. They got a job running which will keep them busy to the early hours, so they'll be about somewhere, all right?
Right, Gov.
Yeah. If my, wife should ring. Tell her I'm...
You're out on a job.
Yeah, but try to make it a bit more convincing than that. Know what I mean, Sarge?
Right, go.
Is this tie all right?
Yeah.
I mean, they run out of clip-ons. You sure it's straight?
Well, hold on. Can I help you, sir? Yeah, what can I do for you?
Yeah, any lodgings around here, Gov?
Lodgings, yeah. Yeah, we've got a list.
It's the torch.
Up there.
Promise to do. It's too late now, isn't it? Call yourself a key man, you can't even mend the bloody lock on the front door. Too late now, isn't it? You'll be on that first bus back in the morning. What am I going to do then? Sat in front of the telly all day. Can't wait to get back to the scrubs, can you? I'm talking to you, Alfie Mullins, you lazy good-for-nothing punts.
It's not my
Well, you've got the torch.
Bloody hell. How do I ever get lumber with you lot?
It's not my fault. Tell him, Andy.
No, he's all right, Carl.
Is that blind drawn?
Yeah.
Eddie, turn on the light. Oh, well done, Edward. It's gonna be a doddle, boys.
Gin and a bottle of scotch. I don't even like gin. I'd have been better off staying in the boozer room.
Why don't you stop moaning? You've been a jinx on this job right from the start. If it's anybody's fault, it's yours.
Oh, that's it. Blame me, Mr. Al Capone.
You did promise, Cole. 50 nicker each, you said,
yeah.
At least.
Okay, so I got it wrong. All right.
Well, that's it.
That silent burglar alarm call at Hussex Sweet Factory. There's no sign of entry, and we haven't been able to get hold of either key holder.
Typical.
Yeah. Perhaps you could get someone to go over and keep an eye on the premises. You never know.
OK.
Oh, and the cell toilet for number 2's out of order.
Is it in the book?
Yep. That's about it, I think.
Oh, what's this?
Oh, God, I've forgotten all about that.
Oh, Galloway?
Yeah. Yeah, he left that number in case we wanted him urgently.
He's like boxing, isn't he?
So what do you reckon they keep in here, then?
Office papers. Bills and things. It might have changed now, though.
Yeah. Well, let's have a look then, shall we?
Torch.
God, blimey.
Bleeding hell.
Told you, didn't I?
Well, you get used to that after a while, don't worry about it.
Oh, night duty day? Yeah.
Got caught, didn't I?
Ooh, how's that?
Well, all the relief's split up at the moment because of the demonstrations uptown. I don't know whether I'm coming or going. I'll be glad to get onto your firm up until we
have. Yeah. Then you could work all the shifts in one go. Every day of the week. See how you like that, Lytton. Ha, ha, ha.
Don't you think you'd better give that stuffy elbow for a while, Eddie? I mean, well, you know what you get.
You're getting to sound like Humphrey Bogart over there. I thought you was my pal.
Cut it out, will ya? Start coming up with some ideas or we're gonna be here all night.
Yeah, why? I bet there's bugger all in there anyway.
Listen, you kid, there's
don't
gotta
call
be...
me a kid, right? Just because I'm younger than you.
Firms don't have safes for nothing. Tell him, will ya? Yeah. Get it into his thick skull.
Oh, do you? You've been on my
you won't ever
do
since
nothing.
Started.
Listen. Cole's right. But could we that much from 40 grand in
there? More like 80.
Oh, here he goes again. An hour ago it was 10, now it's bleeding 80. Any advice on 80, have you, Cole?
Mr. Worted, didn't I? Wouldn't I know?
Look,
would you know?
Let's all have a drink and stop winding each other up, okay?
It's not me, it's him.
Oh, bloody
shit! Shut up, outside!
Shit. Bloody hell, you two. Look, there's got to be an answer to this, so let's work it out together. Like a team, eh? Right. Now, all we need is a bit of concentration, not arguing.
Come on, Eddie, let's have that drink.
Soaking up the punishment,
then,
Bernie?
He's
doing all right, isn't he?
He's doing all right. Hello, that's
more my style. Hello. Do you know her, then?
No, her. Went 5 rounds with her the other night. Tell you what, Bernie, she put up a better fight than your boy.
What's the odds on him now, then, Harry?
Ooh, 4-1 on. Any price you like.
I tell you what, if my man loses, the drinks are on me.
Yeah, I'll hold you that, Bernie. Only one way for your man's going to win. That's to go in there with a plank of wood. That's what
I reckon. Gumshots. Right, Sam?
What do you want, Lytton?
Can't relieve our reserve man for grub, Sergeant.
You're a little early, aren't you?
Yep, well, I thought I'd get it all over and done with when it's all quiet outside.
What about the sweet factory? Another look round?
Safe and secure. Wasted time, like a lot of things in this job. I'll tell you, I'm fed up with going around shaking hands with padlocks.
Off you go, lad. I'm glad, Lytton, this is not your regular relief, or I can foresee you and I having a very unhappy relationship. In future, Lytton, stick to the times allocated and less cheek.
Yes, Archer.
Lytton, are you just going to sit there or are you going to answer that phone?
Sun Hill Police Station.
Oh, hello, Gov. How's the boxing going, all right? Yeah, well, everyone knows. All right, you're going out with the boys, are you? Yeah? Then you'll phone in later, right? Yeah, he's here, right. Sarge, it's Roy Galloway.
Detective Inspector Galloway.
Yeah. He wants to know if there's anything happening.
Tell him it's quiet. And tell him I hope he's enjoying his dinner.
I wouldn't know what day it is, stuck in here for a bit.
No, neither did that geezer from Kentish Town when he hit the canvas. He didn't know what day it was.
The lad's a good fighter. You can't take that away from him. It's only when they try to teach him to box. That's what screwed him up. Stand on me.
That's a load of old pony.
I'll tell you what, Harry. If that fight tonight had been out on the cobbles, I know my money would have been on.
I know my money.
It's not about headbangers, though, is it, eh?
Look, what if we take it with us? And then we could work on it in our own time. My brother's lockup is empty. It won't be just the place.
How are we going to do that without wheels?
I don't know.
Wait a minute. When we came through the yard, under the fire escape.
Oh, not that trolley.
Yeah.
You're not thinking of pushing that through the streets, are you?
Why not?
I don't believe this. Look, you can count me out for a start.
It's been done before.
Oh, yeah?
All we got to do is throw a blanket or something over it and that's it.
No, we'd stick out like a sore thumb. If we're going to do it, it's best to leave it till about 4:30. Be daylight then, people moving about on their way to work in there. Wouldn't look so sussy then, would we?
Well, like I said, you can count me out.
Look, it's not such a bad idea, you know, Eddie.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And why don't we go and break Alfie Mullins out of Nick to do the job for us then, eh? You got to be mad, you two.
Wait a minute, you said Alfie Mullins?
Yeah, why?
Who's Alfie Mullins when he's out?
That's it! No, he's at home. Out, only.
Will somebody please tell me who's Alfie Mullins?
Oh, come on, Michael Caine. You must have heard of Alfie Mullins, the cracksman. There ain't a safe he can't open. As it happens, I know him personally.
Who, Michael Caine?
No, you div, Alfie Mullins.
Do you know where he lives?
Well, not really.
Yeah, I
think he might have moved. I could find out, though. It will take some time. I mean, you can't go knocking up people in the middle of the night, right?
I've got an idea, Eddie. Me and Cole put a safe on a trolley, and when it gets light, we'll take it to the lockup, right? That gives you plenty of time to find out where Alfie lives and bring him along.
To the lockup?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, he's a busy man. What if he don't want to come?
Offer him a 25 grand cup.
Yeah.
Alright. Who's that?
Inspector Galloway. Yeah. Ask the station officer if there's anything doing, would you, son?
No, he done too much of the jabbing, too much left hand. So what he should have done was got stuff in.
Nothing? Right. Cop hold of this number. Just in case.
And don't forget to write this time. Do you hear me, Alfie Mullins?
Sorry to bother you, Alfie. Oh, Mr. Mullins. You don't know me, but... You are Alfie Mullins, aren't you? Yeah, I'd know you anywhere. Well, look, I'll come straight to the point. Me and a couple of pals, we've got hold of this safe seat. We can't get it open, can we? It's right up your street, Alfie. I thought you'd be interested for, say, 25 grand cut. What's the matter, then? Don't me and my mate's good enough for you or something? Oh, I get it, not your class, eh? Look, I'm talking to you, mister. Listen, Mr. Batsby, you're coming with me whether you like it or not.
Shut up!
Oh! Alfie? Don't sob me about, right? A little knock like that ain't gonna...
Speaking. Alfie? Are you sure? No, I'll be over there right away. Yeah, thanks.
Where's Eddie got to? He should have been back hours ago.
No. Not like him, is it? Perhaps he can't find Alfie.
Yeah, well, we can't go on like this. I've hardly made an impression on the bloody thing.
Yeah. I've got to think of something else, that's all.
Have they got in touch with Galloway yet?
Yeah, he's already gone down there.
He's
been crying out there soon.
So he can't do, right? Well, who else has been called out so far?
Oh, well, it's forensics, fingerprints, then we know we get hold of Soko, yeah? And then there's,
Me. Morning.
Is it? I didn't even have time to bloody well shave. I know what all the fuss is about anyway. Something murder, they're two a penny these days.
Well, Galloway's already down at the scene.
Yeah, I know. You get down there too and tell Galloway that I'll set up an incident room. Now, Mike, not tomorrow. I'll drag in the extra manpower.
This is ridiculous, Andy! We've got to have high-speed drills. You just can't do a job like that without them. Where the bloody hell's Eddie got to?
They should have found Alfie's drum by now. I wonder if he's all right.
Yeah, well, I've got a funny feeling he's done a runner. Remember, he's got a few pounds worth of 10p's from that office burning an hole in his pocket.
Burning?
Yeah.
You've just given me another idea, Colin.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that training scheme they put you on when you was on the dock.
What, welding?
Why didn't I think of it before? You must know how to use that... You know, what's it, that oxia stuff?
Oxyacetylene?
That's it.
I mean, it's not the same thing, Andy. Anyway, where are we going to get that kind of gear this time in a moment? Eh?
Morning.
Hey, all right.
Thank you very much, pal. Will you not bloody well keep it down? Can't hear myself. Get out of the way, will you?
How long are we going to be hanging round here, Sarge?
For as long as Galloway wants to keep you here.
All right.
Hi, Roy.
Oh, good morning, God. Get lost for half an hour, will you, pal?
First of all, unless something like your wife's having a baby or your mother's died, there'll be no time off. I want you to get that straight right from the start. No leave until this murder's solved. Any questions? Good. We understand each other. Now, what I'm going to do is tell you briefly what we've got and what line of inquiry I want you to follow. Then you go out and do your house to house or whatever assignment Sergeant Roach has allocated to you. Then we'll meet back here at 7 o'clock tonight to see what we've come up with. Right. First, I'll tell you a little of Alfie Mullins' antecedents. Alfie Mullins... we know the sequence of events, and I want to see you taking some notes, and not in the back of fag packets either. Any of you got a rough book? See Sergeant Roach now before we start. Alfie Mullins left home at 5 o'clock this morning to catch the early morning bus back to prison. His route was through a well-known shortcut, an alleyway alongside the Woodland Graveyard. It's a shortcut for Alfie in more ways than one. Now, our first witness who lives in Andrew Street, it is Andrew Street, isn't it?
St. Andrew Street.
In St. Andrew Street, which is just round the corner from the graveyard, was woken by a man's voice calling after Alfie. Now, seems too much of a coincidence to be anybody other than our Alfie. The time fits Alfie leaving home and the finding of the body. Marks found on the pavement suggest that somebody followed Alfie, then walked alongside him for about 50 yards, eventually blocking his way before the struggle took place. The body, so I'm told by the experts, hasn't been moved, so it looks at the moment as if Alfie fell over backwards, hitting his head on the small stone parapet which runs along one side of the alleyway as he fell. The assailant... You all right?
Yeah.
The assailant then ran away through the graveyard. However, he came face to face with a night watchman as he entered. And the night watchman, pushing his bicycle along the alleyway, minutes later, found the body. Now, this gentleman should have been our big break. Unfortunately, the witness is as blind as a bat, or so he reckons, and is unable to give us a description of any kind, whether black or white, young or old, which hopefully will explain why he was pushing his bicycle and not riding it. However, those are the facts, gentlemen. You now know as much as I do. When we've had a chance later to search every inch of the area, I may be in a position to tell you more. Until then...
Could it have been an accident, sir?
This, my old son, is a murder inquiry until proved otherwise. Now, if there are no more stupid questions, I'll move on. As for motive, I want you to think along these lines when you're making your inquiries. Now, I know some of you may not agree with the way I see it, but I've been totting up the amount of unrecovered money from Alfie's past jobs. I know it's a long time ago, but it comes to well over 80 grand. And my intuition tells me that this is what this business is all about. Somebody, no stranger to Alfie, thought he had or knew where some of that loot was stashed. Follows a pattern we've all seen before. A motive not unusual amongst villains. So if there are no more questions, Tonight, then. 7 o'clock. Good hunting, gents.
Well, that's it.
Roy! Roy!
You're completely wrong about this. I've told you before and I'll tell you again, Alfie has not got a pot. Not a penny. But do you think his missus would be collecting social security if she had 80 bloody grand under the mattress?
Listen, Robert. If you'd have done your duty, Alfie would still be around now to spend it. Think about it.
Thank you.
And, if I were you, I'd get downstairs a bit quick and get changed, because you should have been on duty a couple of hours ago. Station officer, remember?
Come on, Mike.
Caught it this time.
Yeah. You said you knew how to use it.
Well, I do. Only I didn't finish the course, did I? Different equipment anyway, so don't blame me, right?
Yeah, well, you could have told me that before we nicked this gear.
How was I?
I mean, five lockups away was taking a chance. Someone could have seen us dragging it in here.
Because you, Burke, I didn't know.
L-plate moron.
Oh, here he is. Rent a... Where you been, eh? We've been bloody ill.
Carl, can't you see something's wrong?
Sorry, fellas. I must have drunk too much. I woke up on a pinch down the road.
Oh, that's bleeding charming, isn't it? What about Alfie Mullins, our saviour? I mean, that's who you went out for, wasn't it?
Did you find him, Eddie?
Yeah. It took me ages, though. Is there any booze left?
Well?
He's got a big job on, right? He couldn't spare the time, could he?
Would you offer him a cut, like I said?
Sure. He didn't want to know. Look. I like to slap him about a bit.
Oh.
Well, he got a bit naughty.
Oh, no, where'd he?
I might have gone a bit strong.
Well, that's bleeding well, it. Ain't it?
Okay, look, it's just one way left to get this bugger open. It's gonna cost us a lot. And we'll need a mower.
Is it the bitch?
No, it's a dog.
2 days ago.
Sure. I've got to type this up. I've got a copy from these notes. I mean, what's it? What's this word here?
Flow.
What are you going on about? I know you can't speak English. You should be able to write it, though, shouldn't you? You went to bloody Endon. But,
Taffy, don't you go away. I want you.
Thank you.
Take this down to the restroom and do it again, and don't bring it back until it's right, OK?
Yes,
Sarge. Yes. OK. You want him to bring you back?
What, do you want me to do your filing for you? Get it off there. Come on.
Sorry, Sarge.
Taff?
Yes,
thank you very much.
The break-in entered into the crime book. Hussocks, you know, the sweet factory on Beat 8.
Yeah.
Silent alarm went off last night. Bloody thing, where is it? Oh, there you go. Yeah, they had it away with a bloody trolley of all things. I want you to deal with it, OK?
Besides, that's not even on my beat.
Thank you.
Look, while there's a murder investigation going on upstairs, we've got to be a bit flexible,
sorry,
understand?
Yes, sir.
I don't know. I'm afraid there are three people
working. Sarge. About Alfie Mullins. Sorry. I'm still rotten.
No, that's the way it goes, isn't it?
Yes. Sir. Yes,
Taff.
Yes.
No, thanks.
And the safe was the only other thing missing, was it, sir?
Yes, officer. Rather clumsy job. Load of nincompoops, I'd say.
But there was definitely nothing in it.
Not a thing. Or a few old papers, maybe. He stopped using it, let me think, 8 years ago at least. Moved it out of the office when Paul Jenkins died. We had a new floor safe put in accounts. Should have got rid of the old one then, really.
You mentioned having a key.
Oh, in an old tin in the office somewhere.
Right, well, we'll have to get the Socko, the fingerprint man, down here then.
To be honest, officer, whoever they were did me a great service by getting rid of that monstrosity. The trolley, of course, is a different matter. That will cause great hardship in dispatch, and I would appreciate you concentrating your investigations on the trolley, officer, rather than wasting your valuable time on that old safe.
Well, I'll have to put in my report, sir, but we'll keep an eye out for the trolley.
No, I'm much obliged. Oh, and I apologise to your inspector for my partner and I not being available last night. Just one of those things, I'm afraid. Officer, on the house.
Excuse me, Governor. Excuse me.
Somebody's broken into my lockup, nicked all my welding equipment.
Where is your lockup, sir?
Behind the shops, off the parade there. Bloody sods. Those are my working tools. How can I be expected to
what
do a...
What number, sir? The number of your lockup?
Oh, I haven't got a number, have I? It's just Reg Atkins, panel beater. You can't miss the sign, Gov.
Right then, Mr. Atkins. I'll meet you back there in about 5 minutes, all right?
Good on you, Gov.
101 to uniform, Oscar. Over.
Right, yeah. Hold on a minute, Mr. Frank. Yeah. Please, let me get. Hang on a minute, please. Yeah. Okay, right, well, I've just got Mr. Chambers on the other line, Derek. What's going on? Yeah, Mr. Chambers, what I'll do is to get D.C. Robinson to meet you at Council Yard.
Anything new, sir?
Yeah.
Not right at this minute, no go.
Well, probably the time tools, whatever you used to open up
the
drain.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I can't do anything else until I've spoken to Mrs. Mullins again. Yeah. If the Chief Super rings, tell him I'll be late.
All right, Gov.
Oh, you better tell him I've arranged for the post-mortem at midday.
He'll be there in half an hour.
Actually... Perhaps it'd be better if I arranged to meet him there instead. You got that?
Yeah, I got that. Oh, you wanted me to remind you about Cryer. You said you wanted to speak to him again.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, sod it. So I did.
Thank you.
Oh, Tom. Cryer's got a surprise lined up.
For me?
Yeah, for you.
Oh, I see.
Oh, come you in, Ed. It's just the man I want to see, boyo.
But I've got the crime book entries to do, Sarge.
Hey, you haven't got your helmet on.
Why don't you get rid of that kid? We're supposed to be running a murder inquiry, not a bleeding
day nursery, you know.
Look, will you get him back home?
I'm not sure where he lives, Sarge.
Draper, number 32, above the shops on the parade.
I've just come back from there, too.
I'm all day, Bob.
How's that?
Lockup's been broken into, welding equipment and tools been nicked.
Hmm. Well, I'll see you when you get back. Goodbye.
Bye.
Come on, you. Take you home. Come on then, Jenny, show me where you live.
Up there.
Come on then.
Oh, hello, it is. Mommy. Hello. Go on, Jimmy. It's good of you to bring him home, officer.
Now, we were thinking of adopting him, Mrs. Draper. So my sergeant reckons we couldn't afford to keep him in chocolate.
See, it's not all my fault. You encourage him down there, that's what it is. A load of old softies, you lot. I'll stand there grinning like a Cheshire cat. Come have a cup of tea. Just made a pot. Go on, you look as if you need one.
Well, I shouldn't really.
Sit yourself down here, young man. I'll bring it out to you.
Thank you.
It's not often I get visitors these days. Since his father left home, you know. He's been wandering off like this. Used to be a close-knit family. Till she came along.
Mrs. Draper, do you know the three lads that own that lock-up over there?
That one opposite?
Yes.
No, like to, though. Noisy beggars. Had me up since the early hours. They're banging and drilling. All those sparks flying about in there. Don't know what they're up to.
Mrs. Draper, can I use your phone? It's urgent.
Help yourselves in the hall.
You'll see that I'm right, Roy. Don't you worry about that.
You're in a fantasy world, Robert.
You think so?
Hello? Edwards?
A panel beater over here has reported that his lockup's been broken into. His tools and his welding equipment's gone. I mean, over here, just across from where I am at the moment. Mrs. Draper, sir.
Yeah, but hang about, let's get this straight. The panel beater lives just near where your lads were last reported. That right?
Yes, that's right, sir.
Now, this Mrs. Draper, is she reliable?
I think so, sir.
Good. Now, she says they've been drilling and banging since the early hours.
Yes,
right. Now, I'll tell you what to do, my son. Stay put. Don't do anything till I get there. All right? Now, where's this place? Yeah, I know. It's at the back of the parade. That right?
That's right.
Yeah. All right. Right, that's it. I'll be there as soon as I can. You did well, my son. See ya.
Now what, Bob?
Sounds like a job for Alfie Mullins.
Yeah? If he was still alive.
Yeah.
I hate to admit it, but I might owe you an apology. Well, come on then. Let's see if we can get together. Come on, move it.
Edwards, it's a surveyor coming along now.
Yeah, that's them, sir.
What can you say?
Right. We'll give them a moment to go in, settle down. Then we'll go in, box them up nice and neat.
Are in position now. Remember, no messing about, straight in. You ready?
Let's go!
Hello, Dasher! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Control. Get out there. Tell them not to transmit on their personal radios. Old bloody lot will go off. Go on, quick!
Uniform Moscow, uniform 600. Do you read
me? Don't use your radios! Don't transmit!
This is...
What bloody idiot did that?